हेलो, गुड इवनिंग गाइस. आई एम वेरी थैंकफुल टू मिस्टर मुकेश गोस्वामी सर, एज ही हैज गिवन अ चांस टू डिबेट ऑन द टॉपिक ऑफ ब्रेन ड्रेन. माय व्यू इज, बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस टॉपिक आई वुड लाइक टू मेक अंडरस्टैंड दैट व्हाट इज द मीनिंग, प्रॉपर मीनिंग ऑफ ब्रेन ड्रेन. ब्रेन ड्रेन, इट इज द मूवमेंट ऑफ द हाईली एजुकेटेड एंड स्किल्ड पीपल टू अ कंट्री वेयर दे गेट द प्रॉपर proper condition of working and the much more money. It means the people who are highly educated and highly skilled, they actually migrate from one country to another developed country for getting the condition of for getting the favorable condition where they get much more money as compared to their own country. So it is the proper definition of the brain drain. And what were the main reason of the brain drain is, number one is the reservation. That if we talk about India, in India we mainly find the reservation process. Okay, and if you talk about the reservation is somewhat, it's good, and sometimes it's considered to be very bad for those students who are just preparing for their examination from very long time, and only because of few marks they were not selected in their desired examinations. So that's why they were just migrate from our country to another country for getting much more money and for getting much desirable rank. So what's your opinion, Santosh?
My opinion is that the people who study from these by getting the rank, they got the prestigious institutions like IITs and NITs, and they go to study there, and afterwards they have a certain type of mentality. They just imagine from their higher secondary only to they have to settle in the US and they have to get married in the US. So we have to just simply break this kind of mentality, because brain drain is bad for our country, because the talented candidates goes to the US. They should work in our country and should improve our country situations.
Yeah,
there are many factors regarding this also.
Yeah, if the talented person, skilled person and highly educated person, when they migrate from our country, it will directly or indirectly affect our GDP. It means our economy.
Yes.
That they may be, if they want to make any company, okay, they may create the company, okay, but only because of getting much more money, they actually migrate from our country to another country for getting much more money, for getting more and more comfort, more and more facility. Only because of that they migrate from our country. But according to me, it's wrong. Okay, why it's so? Because if they want to create money, if they want to earn more and more money, they may create in India, because India is a very big market, very huge market. Many of the MNCs companies were just, they came from the another country to our country for only because of market. Okay, but our skilled people, most highly educated people, they don't think so about our country, and only they were just thinking about their future, they migrate from our country. So it's wrong. If they really educated, if they really skilled, they may create such types of jobs in our country.
Lots of startups have also been started in India also, and the scenario has been changed from the last 20 years. The earlier 20 years, at that time only they study from these institutions and settle in the countries like USA, South Korea, Germany. But now the scenario has been changed. But I think that these are being more influenced by the youngsters. Basically, it involves many different issues, like social issue, economic issue, the infrastructure of the institution also. Our infrastructure of the institution are, I think, not very good, according to some renowned persons, that they don't provide such facility, such amount of stipend to those students who do their PG, means post graduation, or M.Tech, or PhD in the research field, I am telling. So that's why they just go to the US. But I think that it is wrong, because by going there, they left our country alone, and for our country, it is not good. Basically, the state like the rural state like Bihar and the northeastern states, these are not so educated till now.
Do you know, our country is not able to create much and more jobs. That's why many of the people.
Our country is capable, but all persons are just think that they only want to get the government job.
If you talk about the India is currently situation is considered to be as the developing country, and still do you know what were the poverty yes. ratio is very bad.
Yes,
it means what? Our government cannot able to manage the job situation, cannot able to manage the opportunity of job, or cannot able to give them.
Government is managing.
Actually, I'm not talking about the government jobs.
I am talking about the whole job. The government job is for the government purpose. That will be under by the union. Basically, the union.
Yeah, it's government. Managed by the union government.
Yes, union government. Mm-hmm. And I'm talking about the private jobs. Basically, the Atmanirbhar Bharat scheme. These schemes have been launched due to which many startups are being in raising.
But do you know when we talk about the facility, when we talk about the salary?
Yes.
Okay, as compared to another foreign countries, in India the peasants and the laborers they get the less money as compared to foreign companies. That's why most of the laborers
and labor go to the South
Saudi Arabia and many countries only because of that. So actually
only due to peasants and the laborers, this country is not running. This country is basically running about the this country is running basically due to the tertiary sector.
Actually, it's not about the
tertiary and secondary sector.
Yeah, it is not about the
peasant and laborer. These are included in the primary sector basically.
Do you know? And if you talk about the tertiary sector, in tertiary sector, laborers were also used.
Laborers were also sector. Used,
but wherever but the, we talk about?
But the talented person, those yeah. persons who are the CEOs or the directors.
Only tertiary sector cannot be run by the CEOs or yes, the I MD.
But I think due to those person who just migrate there, it is not a very big task about.
Do you know
but,
why
but,
the?
But these
if
people.
If you talk about the highly educated people, they were also migrated from the our country. Do you know what were the main reason? Because in the foreign countries, they found the favorable working conditions. Okay, only because of favorable working conditions.
These
and
favorable conditions, they just think about themselves. But after going there and settling at that position,
yeah.
like countries like USA, they just begin to feel the culture of that country.
But do you know? Recently, I saw a news in America, many of the guys who were just Indians. Belong from the Indian culture, they were just celebrating the Chhath festival in America. So,
yes,
you can't blame that by just moving from
that
migrating
celebrating
from.
Celebrating festival is another case. Recently, Chhath Puja has been just. The government has issued a policy that this festival holiday will also be included in their constitution. So that is basically is going on.
In national holidays.
Yes, the Chhath Puja, this is the first time that they are celebrating in America.
Yeah.
And maybe I think that they will give chance to another Indian festival also, like Diwali or Holi also.
So it's good.
To celebrate. But I think that people should stay here only after getting the job. The government should have to do by the help of big task force, this can be done. Because the student mindset has to be changed economically, financially. Because I have seen that in the higher education, here people don't get such amount of stipend. If they really just,
Actually, I'm going to give some example. If you talk about the Paras Agarwal, Parag Agarwal has recently become a Twitter CEO, and if you talk about the Sundar Pichai, he is the CEO of the Google.
Yes.
They were the Indians. Okay. Why they were just migrating from India to another country? Because such platforms, such a high level platform, they can't find in India. That's why they were just decided to migrate from India.
So I think that they should think about India also. And if they should have stayed here, then our country situation may have been in a good situation.
Initially, they tried more, much more, but they can't find any governmental supports and the other supports. That's why they were just decided to migrate from India to another country.
That's why I'm telling about the government. That the government should make such kind of policies also.
Yeah.
Government should think about it. Why the youngsters are thinking like the Western way of culture of living. They just want to settle at the USA, South Korea, this kind of metropolitan cities and the country like this.
And if you talk about the brain drain, I think it's good. Why it's so? Because any of our working professionals and the skilled person, if they migrate from our country to another country for getting higher educations, and if they migrate in the highly developed country, which are developed country, if they migrate at that country, actually they get much and more knowledge as compared to our country. And they, when they come to our country, it will be beneficial or boon for us.
They don't come in our country. They just settle there and do their job and increase the GDP of that country.
No, you
they
are
basically become the citizen of that country. Yes, yeah. that is happening.
Among them, some of the students or working professionals, they come to our country. Among them,
very few. In 100, I think 10 people will come. After getting those facilities, why they will come in our country? They will just want to stay there at those country only. I want to tell about the government that government should make such type of policies and should create awareness among the student that and financially they should support the student also for getting the higher education, and they should provide a good amount of stipend so that the children don't go to those countries and study.
From ancient time, government had launched such types of programs. That's it. Yeah, from previous times. Okay, like if you talk about the PhD, if any person wants to research
Do you know how much amount of PhD?
25,000.
Yes, only 25,000.
Yeah.
I have also cracked the gate one time I got the PhD, but I left it because due to the very less amount of stipend provided by the institution.
Yeah, it's monthly, I think.
It's monthly, but it is less also, but I think it is less. By giving many different exams like
actually as we are under the developing country, so if you talk about the developing country, I think it's okay. 25,000 is okay.
I think it is not okay.
As we are under the developing country, it's okay, because if you talk about the salary of a constable is also getting money, I think 18 to 22,000 or 25,000. Between the 20 to 25,000.
His total salary is approximately 33,000. 33,000. Yes. But for getting higher education like PhD, these amount are very less regarding to those institutions like Harvard and the MIT, Massachusetts Institute of Technology.
Yeah, actually, many of the working professionals and many of the skilled persons, why they were just migrating from our country? The main reason is infrastructure.
Infrastructure, of course. Yes.
They can't find such infrastructure in which they utilize their skills. Okay, it is a very important or main issue of brain drain. Okay, so I think so. If the government wants to make them stop in our country, make them stop such people who have
Government can't stop any person. If a person wants to go and settle abroad, they will settle.
First of all, tell me why they were just migrate from our country? Only because of the good infrastructure, good lighting style.
I will tell about this. Why they were migrating? Due to good infrastructure of research, they are getting good infrastructure for developing a good research, and they will get a better stipend or salary there, and they will get a better service there with comparison to our India.
Yeah.
these things, government should think about this. What students' mindset is there, and the government should think about this and should work seriously on this. Because if this thing will happen, our nation will be always be a developing country only.
Do you know what was the main issue? Government is going to be, create such types of programs. Okay. Implement such types of program, they can make such types of program, but the main thing is implementation of that program. It cannot be happen in a good manner.
Yes.
Okay. Because like many programs like Atmanirbhar Yojana, okay, government is just providing much more money for the startup, but the
government is not providing directly.
Yeah.
There are many loopholes inside this. Basically, they are just providing the amount, loan amount. The person who didn't have such amount of money, they will just take loan for starting a business or creating a startup company. If they will earn, if they will get profit, then by slowly they will give the amount back to the government.
I think the process is become the barrier in for creating such things.
Yes.
Okay. So I think government should make such a plan that that can change the mentality of our investors and the skilled persons. Okay. But the current situation, if we talk about the brain drain is good. Why? If we think about the 10 people out of 100, 10 people were just come back to India only because they have the feeling of patriotic. Okay. It will be boon for us.
There can be many reasons why they are coming from India. There may be one of the people's some guardian has been expired. Any situation can happen.
Yeah, but the people who are just coming come India only because of their patriotic feeling, if they get the much more knowledge there, the advanced knowledge in compared to India, and they come to India, it's become boon for our country. Okay.
I want to tell one situation, one example of why brain drain is bad. I'm telling about it. We know about the Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, such a highly skilled and professional person. He was also our former president also. He basically got the opportunity after clearing the exams in his college. Basically, he was reading in a very prestigious institute. I'm just forgetting the name of that.
Which, in foreign?
It is located in, not foreign, it is located in India, in southern India.
Oh.
And from there, he wanted to join the Indian Air Force, but he didn't able to join the Indian Air Force because his somehow marks were less. So that's why...
Actually, the fact is, he's not physically fit.
No. He was physically fit, but due to some reason, some marks, his name was not in the top 5 list. So he didn't get the chance to join the Indian Air Force. And after that, he just signed the contract with... signed contract not, he just joined the DRDO. And from there, his career begins. And by joining the DRDO, and his knowledge were very good. That's why NASA also contacted from Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam that you should join the NASA. We will give you better facilities and more salary regarding the ISRO, we will give you. But Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam just simply neglected that situation. He just totally, he just simply told that I will not go to NASA.
Actually, he denied to go there.
He denied, yes. Yeah. He totally denied. And he told that I will work for my country. And from there, his career begins and today we know about the Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. That is all about his history, how he became the president.
Do you know why I'm supporting the brain drain? Because it is a time of globalization. Okay, in which many countries were just
globalization. You are telling, but it is also a very deep meaning of globalization.
Yeah.
Yes.
It can
hamper the whole country also. You are just seeing the situation what China is doing by globalization. He is just investing his money and he just providing the infrastructure for the name of the development for those
and
countries.
After,
and after the development, those poor people,
actually,
poor country,
China make them helpless.
Yes, they just China just over. He just overtake the those countries, those poor countries.
Yeah.
Yes, and so, he is making the colonies.
Yeah, actually, I'm talking about the globalizations. Okay. In which what many MNCs companies they were came to India and many Indian companies were also going to settle in the European countries or the other countries. Okay, in which what the working officials, okay, they were also Indians. Okay, and if any working officials, working skilled people, when they migrate from our country to another country for working purpose. And after getting much and more knowledge and experience, after getting, when they come to our country, because many of the MNCs companies were also settled in our country, when they come to join the same company but in the Indian branch, they were also getting the same salary in India too. Okay.
No, how they will get the same amount of salary? If a person is receiving amount, I am telling an example. Basically, what happened from the IITs? The students who got selected from the IITs and go to the abroad. Basically, after settling to the US, they got the package. I'm telling about with a comparison with India. In terms of Indian rupees, they are getting the package of rupees. I think 1.5 crore to 2
crore. Actually,
you are
talking about the Fraser. Actually, I'm talking about the much more experienced person who have experience and company.
After fresher, he will be experienced after 2 years.
Yeah.
Those person are called experienced, which have 1 to 2 years or experience. 1 to 2 years experience.
The companies, the person, the company who need that person.
Hmm.
Okay. The company is ready to pay any amount for that person. Okay. Actually, I have a live example of one of the uncle. Okay. He work in abroad. Okay, earlier, and in Colt company. Colt is a communication company in the Europe. Okay, Colt, COLT, Colt. I don't have remember the name of that particular country. I don't have remember. Okay, he worked there. Okay, in Colt, and one of the his branch MNCs companies is at Bengaluru. Yeah, and he worked as the data scientist, data analyst. Okay, and. When he transferred in India, okay, he get the same amount, he get the much more amount in compared to that country. Our star players were not getting so much of value in as compared to the foreigner cricketers. Why it's so? It is not
the mentality of the people.
Same thing I'm going to define. Okay. That it is a mentality, and why its mentality just come in our peoples only because they were actually come from the highly developed countries. Okay, their technology is very developed.
That
their
point
skill,
I was talking about. That is called the peer pressure. That thing is called basically the economical, financial, and social issues. These play a vital role in brain drain. Basically, government should. Think about this because economically they are not providing good stipend to the students or postgraduates and PhD students. Financially they are not supporting them, and socially what's happening? Socially they create
people are not going to accept them.
They create mindset up like this. The Western culture is very good.
And if any guys who are just wants to research in any field, people, our society is not going to accept them. They were just scolding them that.
Yes, what he will do in India?
Yeah.
After getting PhD, which job you will get? You will get nothing. These kind of things have been told in our country.
Yeah.
But after going
abroad,
they get more benefits. So government should think about this, and these things should be stopped.
Yeah, I think so. Government is the most. Responsible.
Government is responsible, and the people are also responsible, which are living in our society.
Actually, the peoples will run according to the government.
And
as the government going to be make any types of law, peoples will
and
also
government should think that the skillful person should be become more in our country. Basically, government is implementing those type of syllabus which are not relevant to our daily life. It is basically what? Just waste. That syllabus is.
Unusual things.
Yes. What is the purpose of A plus B whole square? This formula, we can't apply in our daily situation, life.
Actually, I don't know. Government should make such plans and government
what
should...
What is the need of sine, theta and cos theta? These things are not for our daily purpose.
Daily purpose.
But government should try to improve the skills. It's basically, government should teach those types of skills to students which they can use in our daily life. Like they are just including in our new education policy also. They are including many skills like sewing and
coding
also they are including, and carpentry also they are
including. Government is just implementing
science.
Many things.
Home science is basically government one is, of the major factors.
Yeah, government also is going to be implementing many things for the upliftment of such guys, such skilled guys. But I think so, government should also make such plan which will be helpful for those skilled guys who are just going to migrate from our country to another country. It means government should make such plan for them. Okay. Do you know, many of the guys who have just came from our country to another country, like they were just moved our country to Canada. They easily get the our citizenship of Canada,
yes.
And when they settle there, they start up their own business. Okay, why they so? Because the policy which were the made by the Canada government is very preferable for them.
Yes.
Okay, so I think so government should make and work on such policy which were the beneficial for that such skilled persons.
Government should make those kind of policies by which people don't go to foreign countries. Basically, foreign people should come in our countries and invest money in our country.
Okay, if you talk about the brain drain, from where it's the concept of brain drain is just coming the concept in our peoples.
From where?
From actually talking about the time period. From when?
Time period basically, I think that
during
the colonial period. Yeah. Basically, when Britishers started ruling in our country, these situations arises because. Due to their mentality, whole world is suffering from
actually,
this.
Actually, for the labor purpose,
yes.
Okay, they were forcefully forced our people and
yes.
They carried that person to their own country
yes.
For the laboring purpose.
Laboring purpose. They don't carry. They simply give hunters.
Yeah, that's why I'm putting the word forcefully.
Yes, at the
yeah.
They were just they hunter the at the back of the people
yeah.
and tell them to just do the job.
Yeah.
Yes.
And
they also don't give money to them sometimes also.
Yeah, that is called the begari systems.
Yes.
Yeah, work without payment.
Yes.
Yeah. So
those kind of things were happening at that time. These aristocrat, you have earlier told.
You don't think so. What are the reservation is also acting as such things in our India.
I think that reservation should be there in our country because there are many backward classes also which haven't get those kind of facilities earlier.
Do you know when we talk about the initial? Do you know about in the?
You know about the four different castes.
Varnas.
Yeah.
Varna systems.
Yes.
Yeah. Brahmins, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas, Shudras.
Yes. The Shudras, those were
untouchable.
They were very very low background people.
Actually, they were not.
And government is trying to just improve their. Background structure.
Okay, I'm going to define it. Okay, at the when before the 1947, when our country is not going to be get freedom. Okay, they were discriminated. They were exploited on
yes.
the on the based of, on their caste, on the base of their colors. Okay, and they were not going to enter in the temple. It means the higher class people were just. Harm their mentality.
Yes.
Okay. It means the people, they were also not getting the proper education. They were also not getting the proper medical facilities. That's why they were backward in our society.
Yes.
Okay. But after 1947, when the constitution is going to be made, they were getting much value, because in our preamble, whenever we talk about our preamble, in our preamble, award equality is given there.
But this thing is not happening in a fast or a rapid way. These things is happening very slowly.
But do you know?
But in our countries nowadays also, many discriminations like things happens in now also.
Same thing. In the current situation, the person who are just called the Harijans, the person who are previously they called the untouchables, they were get the prosperity in our current society.
Yes.
Okay, such things were going to be extinct. Okay.
But not all of them. Guys.
And if you talk about if on what basis you are going to be give the reservation, poverty.
On what basis? Yes, poverty.
Poverty. And I have the live example. Many of the Brahmin people,
yes.
Many of the Brahmin people who were just begging the money for his livelihood.
Yes, they are also getting reservation in the EWS category. Government has made this.
If
that person is belonging to general category and basically he don't have income, he have less income and don't have a very much amount of land, he comes under the EWS category and he can apply for the EWS
category. But do you know
EWS category, and he will get the reservation facility.
But the politics is also there. Okay, many of the people who were just part of the corruptions, and only because getting the benefits of such things, they were included themselves in the
EWS category. Yes.
Yeah.
I think it is wrong. Yes.
Yeah. That's why I'm blaming the reservation systems. I think government should make a new plan that every people are considered to be as a general. Okay. Then the man
You are just totally what you are just trying, you are just
Actually, I'm not going to support the Stalin.
If the hand is broken, you are just telling. If the hand is broken, simply cut the hand.
Actually,
this thing you are telling.
You don't think so? Many of the peoples who were just belong from the.
There are many low background peoples who haven't get now also such kind of opportunity to study to enhance their skills. That's why government is. Implementing the reservation system and
only,
these things.
I found there is no such guy who is just in our society currently who is just suppressed by the upper
society.
Classes.
You are living here.
Yes.
Here.
Yes.
You are talking about this sector 12.
Yes, sector 12.
But I am talking about the whole country. Visit to the tribal areas where people are not getting facilities like this.
Do you know? Right now we are under the tribal areas.
Yes, we are.
Okay, but so I but
go in
do
the
you know?
Go in the Petarwar area or
do you know
or,
when
or
I
Dumka area
when I visit when that. I visit to Satanpur.
Yes.
Okay, it is totally tribal area.
Yes.
So when I visit to Bisabasa, what I found? I found many types of many KTM bikes, many Pulsar bikes. I found that. Tires
so
under their house.
KTM.
Let me complete first.
KTM by
Let
purchasing
me...
KTM, they you don't you should not think that they are get they have become advanced.
They have become advanced
from the mentality, not from the KTM bike.
Okay.
They just put a leather jacket and just.
From where they get money? Number one thing. From where? Number one is reservation. Only because of reservation, by just getting the 30 to 40 marks, they get easily jobs. But what were the generals? What about the generals?
Yes.
After getting the 80 and 82 marks, generals can't get that job. And after getting the 40...
after getting 80 marks, general also will get. Yes.
But actually, I'm talking about the average marks. Okay.
Not...
And what about the person who is just getting the 30 to 40 marks? They get the job easily. Okay.
Yes,
and
because in ancient time, they have suffered a lot of pain. In their mind,
it means the coming era. It is the term of the generals that they have to suffer such things.
Yet we will discuss it about 50 or 60 years later, when that type of situation will arise at that time, that generals would get the reservation.
Do you know
mode.
The constitution?
Then the constitution will give reservation to general.
No. Actually,
But now this situation is
going to be made, there is declaration that this Program is only for 5 years.
10 years.
No, no, 5 years. After that is get extended. But do you know, only because of the political yes, issues, yes. Not any government is going to be ended that types of systems. So it will be loopholes for our country.
It is basically for the voting purpose. I am telling, yes. To get the vote from those communities, government is extending the time.
Can period. You tell me one thing? In another country,
yes,
many of the salary system was also there in the foreign country.
Yes, in foreign.
But the slab in the foreign country, they can't get such reservation facilities. Even now, they were the become very
they get developed reservation. Country. They get reservation in different aspects, not in the education only.
So same
at, at America also, the black people, they get reservation because they are black. Basically, in America, the main peoples were simply the poor Europeans. The poor European colonies were there. Those were called Americans, basically. And from India, the people go to America. Basically, they are talented. They are just they have been studied from the top institution of our country, like IITs or IISc Bangalore. They go there and just do their job. So that's why in America, Indians are more talented, but the Africans, the black peoples, they at the past time, basically the slave from the British colony, from the Africa, they were just simply put and dragged to those places. Basically, that's why they have low mentality there, and that's why they also get reservation.
They get reservation, but different aspect.
So, but in India, they are getting reservation.
But in India, it is become the political play.
Become the political play because now also I have seen, go and just look at the data. How much general peoples are there in the government jobs.
Working officials.
Basically, all kind of government jobs, I am telling. All the state government jobs and central government jobs. Basically, I think 60 to 70% general category peoples are working in the central government job and state government job also. So that's why I think reservation is needed.
I don't think so. In current situation, reservation is required. Okay. And I think the people who are just suppressed, earlier, they have the upgraded mentality right now. In the current situation.
No, they don't have upgraded mentality. Just go and visit to some village and you should stay some
months. It means what? You were just saying that in villages only the lower caste peoples were lived.
Not lower caste people.
So
I'm talking about those community. You should live with them, with those community people,
yeah.
Like SC or ST. And you should go through to their lives and think about it, what they do in their daily life.
I found many of the villages in which the genders and OBCs were live. Okay, but there, if you talk about their living condition, it is very painful. Okay, it is not so good.
Painful in what regards?
Financially and economically. It means what?
The BJP government has generalized a new reservation category also, EWS.
But the politics is also happened there. No?
And for the poor people also, government provide them in 2 rupees a bundle of rice and wheat, yes.
So it's not justice for them that rice and
earlier what I had told, this thing will not change rapidly. It will take time. It is going on slowly, and our India will.
So you don't think that reservation is work as a barrier for developing our country in developing our country?
No, it works simply as an amplifier. It is amplifying our country. Yes, it is.
Actually, I'm not in favor of you.
It is amplifying the those backward people, basically.
Okay, so I feel very happy to debate with you on the brain drain topic. And so finally, our conclusions. My conclusion is that brain drain is maybe it have some disadvantage, but I found many of advantage that whenever the people who are just migrate from our country to another country, when they come back to our country, it will become the boon for our country. So what's your opinion? Please give your solution.
I mean totally not agree with the this brain drain. I am totally against with the brain drain, because government should make such kind of policy so that people, the talented people, should stay in our country and try to develop our country more. And basically they should advance with those facilities like economical, financial and social issues, so that students of our country, basically teenagers, they should think about the Indian culture more and should be in the limit and should always support the Indian culture and be in the favor of Indian culture.
So guys, thank you. It's our small opinion, is our less opinion about the brain drain. And if you also want to conclude some point, please visit at the comment box and like our video, subscribe it, share it. Thank you.